This video is sponsored by Surfshark.
Oh, hi there. I didn't see you. Yeah, that was kind of lame. Cut that out. Hey everyone, Ta here. So, I've been using the Galaxy Tab S7 Plus for about a week now. If you're unaware, yes, Samsung is still producing Android tablets. They're one of the only manufacturers that still wants to compete with the iPad Pro. But hey, competition is always good for us consumers. So kudos to them. I reviewed the Tab S6 last year, and earlier this year, I also reviewed the Tab S6 Lite. As someone who uses the 10.5-inch iPad Pro, which came out in 2017, I felt like those Galaxy Tabs didn't do enough to make me want to fully switch over. This time around, I'm seriously tempted. A big part of that is due to the display. The screen is next level. It's seriously so good. Over the years, I've realized consuming media is the number one use case of a tablet for me. Nothing beats cozying up in bed at night to a nice movie or TV show. This is definitely the display you want for that. The wider aspect ratio just frames content so well. AMOLED screens are known for their inky blacks. I kid you not, on some black loading screens, it looks like the display is not even on. I seriously thought I hit the power button by accident so many times. Now, it's not completely perfect though. I did notice, at super low brightness, the screen has this slight green haze. I dealt with the same thing on my Pixel 4 XL, but truthfully, I never have it below 20% brightness, so I'm not too bothered by it. 120Hz really feels like it's what Samsung was missing to give their tablets that fluid user experience, especially if they want to compete with how smooth the iPads are. Could I live without 120Hz? Sure, but I definitely notice it, especially with gesture navigation and the various multitasking options. Things just feel so much smoother all around. So you've got the typical Android multitasking from the Recents menu, where you just tap the icon and hit open in split screen view. That works, but I find it a little clunky. I actually prefer using the app tray here, which is built into the Edge panel. The top four will show the apps you used recently, and underneath that, you can pin up to 22 of your favorite apps. From here, it's as simple as drag and drop. To resize the windows, you just drag the line between the two apps. Yeah, you can see how smooth that is. You'll also notice a little indicator at the top of each app, which tells you which one is currently active. You can open a third app with the same gesture, but it's limited to only the right side, with the third app sharing that same space. You can also rearrange the apps to your liking by holding the bar at the top of the app, dragging it into the new position, which automatically swaps them. The icing on the cake has to be the ability to save your multitasking setup as an app pair or trio. Let's say you use this three app setup all the time. Well, to save it, just tap the three dots in the middle and hit this icon here. And just like that, you now can easily launch the exact setup. Super helpful and something I've been using a lot. On top of that, you can open apps in the pop-up view, move it wherever you want, and even minimize and stack apps in a small icon to pull up when needed. Keep in mind, this is all done in tablet mode. I haven't even touched on the multitasking capabilities of DeX, which gives you that more traditional desktop style layout. The key takeaway? This tablet is a multitasking monster. I know not everyone uses their tablet like that, but if you do, you're gonna love it. The S Pen stylus comes bundled with the tablet, which honestly is a really nice selling point. So to charge, the pen magnetically attaches to the back along the stripe here. Just make sure the tip is facing the camera like this here. Samsung also included magnets at the top of the tablet as a place to stow the S Pen for quick access while in use. The writing experience is very good with the 9-millisecond response time. The S Pen is lightweight, has decent grip, and the flat edge actually means that it doesn't roll around on a table. I don't really do art on my tablets, but note-taking, annotating documents, editing photos, and signing contracts have been a perfectly smooth experience so far. The one thing I always do on every single Samsung tablet is download some sort of screen orientation app. Certain apps like YouTube Studio or Instagram just won't rotate to landscape, making for an awkward experience. Although it isn't Samsung's fault, they've added an option in Multistar, which is one of their customization apps, to force apps to work in landscape. It's not the ideal solution, but it beats having to constantly rotate the tablet, especially one this big. App optimization still isn't ideal. A lot of apps just don't take advantage of the bigger display. So here's Twitter, for example, compared to how it looks on the iPad. If you get in the habit of just opening these unoptimized apps in a pop-up window or a split screen, it becomes much less of an issue. Also, if you stick to mainly Samsung and, for the most part, Google apps, the experience is solid. Hopefully, with foldable phones getting more popular, we'll start to see more tablet-optimized apps on Android. I'm not a heavy gamer by any means, but after trying Xbox game streaming, I was really impressed. Think of it as the Netflix for gaming. All you have to do is pair a Bluetooth controller and you've got yourself an awesome gaming experience anywhere with good Wi-Fi. The graphics aren't spectacular. I think it's 720p, but it's a lot of fun. My husband was blown away and pretty much spent the first few nights trying game after game and kept yelling at me to come look. The large portable display makes the Tab S7 Plus the perfect match for a service like Xbox Game Pass. Just like today's video sponsor, Surfshark is the perfect match to keep your online data secure. Surfshark is a VPN used to encrypt the internet traffic sent to and from your devices. This ensures nobody can see where you are and what you're doing online, especially relevant on unsecure public Wi-Fi. While visiting Japan, I fell in love with several Japanese shows on Netflix, but to my disappointment, they weren't available when I got back home. With Surfshark, I've been able to bypass the geo restriction and continue to watch without physically being in Japan. What's really crazy is that there's no limit to the number of devices you can connect at a time. So with one account, the whole family can stay secure too. Try Surfshark now by clicking the link below and using my promo code TAO. You'll get 83% off and 3 months completely free. I've always been a fan of tablets. I know foldable phones are starting to take off, but it's really nice having a screen like this. One that's separate from my phone and one that I can use for light work or play. Anyways, I'm gonna have to spend some more time testing this, but look out for my full review soon. In the meantime, drop any questions down below and I'll do my best to answer them. As usual, thank you all so much for watching. Until the next one, I'm out of here.